you know, you think if you're going to scam somebody, you might not give them your actual address, you know, your actual name, your real phone number. I got a hold of the police down there. They got me to a detective who was like, all right, let me try to figure this out. And it was kind of interesting because he was like, truck probably never existed. You know, this guy's probably not even real. And I'm like, no, he's real. Let me give you all the information I have on a silver platter. And he was like, that doesn't make any sense. That's not how these things work. We see these things every day. The truck's not real. The guy's not real. You're probably just out of luck. You know, I sent him everything I had, and after a few conversations, he was like, it seems like it's real. There's no way someone would be this dumb. He actually went to the guy's house, knocked on the door, talked to him. The guy called me, the detective, and was like, this is the strangest case I've ever seen. These people have no record, crystal clean. They've never done anything illegal ever. And he gave you all of his real information. If he was gonna scam you or stiff you, you had everything. I'm like, I know, a year ago that I gave you guys.